Hey there, Donnie with Prosperity Mortgage Advisors. I'm coming to you once again live from the shop. And yes, we have another great show for you and your whole crew tonight. So listen, normally we all like to get out and go listen to live music. Well, thanks a lot, COVID. That hadn't been much of a deal the last little bit. But if you'll think about it, while we are starving to get out and feel that energy and be around live music and hear it, have a nice cold one, relax with a loved one, just as much as we've been feeling that, these guys that you're going to see tonight have been starving to give it to you, right? They've been like a caged up tiger, so you're going to get to see them tonight pour their souls out for you. I hope you enjoy it. Enjoy this new show live from the shop.
Should be thunderous applause. That's all I've got to say. 50 Shades of Hate, guys, thanks for being here. Appreciate it. Eamon, how are you guys? Rory, Paul.
Hey, hey, hey.
Wendy, David.
Howdy.
Wait. Xander, I had it. Because we just met. I'm sorry. I've known everybody else for years and years. Anyway, guys, it sounds fantastic. So welcome to Live from the Shop. Thank you for being here.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, this is awesome. I mean, there really should be like 300 people in here. So you guys play at the Palace, right? Do a
yes.
lot of gigs at the Palace.
The Nashville Palace.
The Nashville
since
Palace.
2014.
Is that when the band started?
Yes.
Oh, wow, really?
Some of these guys were already there, though, in a different band, the Spaghetti Westerneers.
Oh,
with
that's
Jesse
right.
Lee Jones.
That's right, with Jesse. That's yeah. right. So this was born from that.
Yes.
How cool is that? That's awesome. So 2014. All right. So, Wendy, did you start at the Palace? Where did you start?
Well, I had been in Nashville already singing demos and writing songs, doing writers' nights. And
you had good gigs.
Trying to get the record deal. You know the story.
Yeah.
And so I had been singing, and but then there was maybe a 1 or 2 year period where I hadn't done any performances in a while. So this was a beautiful opportunity to get back to doing what I love.
Yeah,
and I've been doing it ever since.
Yeah. Oh, this. I mean, how could you not do this? This is awesome, guys. It's fantastic. Thank you for being here. What's your next song?
Our next song is Over My Shoulder, and Rory Hoffman will tell you about it.
Yeah, I found this. I heard this on an old cassette tape that my grandpa had, but I didn't know who it was when I was a kid, and it took me forever to actually track down this song and find it. And it was actually written and sung by Mel Tillis, but he recorded it with the Bob Wills Band. So it's kind of like,
oh, wow,
Western swing music meets country music. And so it's not an oft-heard song, so I kind of wanted to bring it back a little bit. It's a nice little ditty called Over My Shoulder, and it features our wonderful twin fiddles.
Beautiful. I can't believe we have twin fiddles in the house, everybody. Live from the shop, 50 Shades of Hay.
2, 3. But your dreams were bigger than mine. You wanted more than I could afford. I was just a fool that you used for time, oh darling. Just looking over my shoulder, and I believe that you could do no wrong. You were just looking over my shoulder for another fool like me to come along. Living. Then you took my living away. When you walked out on me, those things I couldn't see still come around to haunt me. Just looking over my shoulder, and I believe that you could do no wrong. You were just looking over my shoulder for another fool like me to come along.
Fabulous Rory Hoffman, right there. Well, we are the 50 Shades of Hay. We play old-fashioned, traditional, hillbilly country music. We don't play none of that modern rubbish around here. So don't you be asking for it. You hear me?
Rubbish!
We ain't gonna do it. We play country music, we play bluegrass music, and we pronounce it correctly.
Bluegrass.
Bluegrass.
I've been practicing.
Been training these hillbillies to speak English since 2014. It's not working.
I believe that's how Xander and Paul met, was they were smoking bluegrass.
This is a song about my uncle, my favorite uncle, Uncle Penn. He used to play his fiddle out there on the porches of southeast London, and people would come from far away to hear him play. Oh, yeah. Kick her off, Xander.
High rang, you'd hear it talk, you'd hear it sing. Well, he played notes in the cold soldier's jaw and played the one called the Boston Boy. First of all was Ginny Lynn, me that's where the fiddle begins. Heading in the fiddle, loaded high, rang, you'd hear it talk, you'd hear it sing. Loading high rang, you'd hear it talk, you'd hear it sing. Hey, even a bustin' down, high on the hill above the town. Play the fiddle, loading high rang, you'd hear it talk, you'd hear it sing.
Okay, so this is an original song. This is hopefully going to go on our next record. And I wrote this with my friend Logan Ledger, and I love country shuffles, and here's a country shuffle about a woman who's mad and had enough.
3, 4, 1.
Feel like a big
so small. When you cut her down, you show the world you're not a man at all. You thought you found someone to be your forever lovesick fool, but you were wrong. Forever's gone and she is too.
This next song is going to feature the gentleman, the best dressed guy in the band tonight. In his vintage circa 1980s hee-haw overalls.
Just so you know, they smell better than they look.
He's never washed them, y'all.
Never will.
And that's true. He puts them in the freezer after every gig.
But I don't use these in the garden either.
You know why he puts them in the freezer?
Why? I have to jump in here. I have to know.
Because if you put them in the freezer, the cold temperature, it kills the bacteria that causes the odor from sweat.
You shouldn't tell guys that, because there's going to be chest freezers flying off the shelves and clothes dryers.
We have two freezers.
Yeah.
You'll want a freezer just for your clothes.
Works out. Wendy says, where's all your dirty clothes at? I'm like, I thought you wanted me to put the socks in the freezer. I'm sorry, I misunderstood the situation. All right, here's another Mel Tillis. Heavy Lane said, a little touch of hillbilly, Ricky Skaggs, hillbilly, and a touch of moonshine.
Don't you love me no more? It's cold outside, let me sleep on the floor. Honey, won't you open that door? Well, a honky-tonk around Dallas got in a poker game. Somebody must have been cheating. Lord, I lost everything but my name. So I walked halfway back to Memphis, finally got back home. I'd have been better off where I was, 'cause here's where things went wrong. Oh, honey, 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 won't you open that door? This is your sweet daddy, don't you love me no more? It's cold outside, let me sleep on the floor. Honey, won't you open that door? My friend, the landlord says, you know Bob's not here. Oh, the police done hauled him in. So I honky-tonk back to honey's place, but I brought me a rocking chair. I got it at Cracker Barrel. Honey, if you don't open that door for me, I'm gonna rock on away from here. Go back to Cracker Barrel, get me a pancake breakfast. Honey, honey, won't you open that door? This is your sweet daddy, don't you love me no more? It's cold outside, let me sleep on the floor. Honey, won't you open that door? Oh, honey, 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 honey,
honey. Yeah, I said, honey, won't you open that door?
David Spicher.
It's cold outside. Woo! Guys, sounds fantastic. So listening to you guys, obviously the instrumentalist part of it is killer, but How many hours have you spent on harmony? Like an hour, hour and a half?
Point four, point five.
Yeah. Well, you got to add up all the gigs that you've played, you know.
Yeah,
right?
You know, we haven't had a lot of vocal rehearsals, but...
Just pick a part and
example,
go.
Well, for example, Rory did the vocal arrangement for the very first song we did tonight, yep. Old Fashioned Love. And you did all, you recorded all of the parts, right? And then,
Sent
them to us.
Sent them, Dropboxed it.
Sent everybody
them.
Their own part.
He did all the hard work.
There you go.
Wow. Honestly, there's probably a job for you in Nashville doing just that for people. I okay. promise you there is, because I know playing with Susie, she'll send us parts. Paul, you know you played with Susie. She'll send parts, and it'll be like, thank you, because I couldn't find it. You know what I mean? Especially on Christmas music, you know.
Oh yeah, I'm Christmas musician to the stars. That's when they want to hire me, because they want all the they want all the weird instruments that they don't usually
right.
want. You know, so like when I did the Casey Christmas, I worked with Casey Musgraves for a Christmas tour, and I worked with Kathy Mattea for a Christmas tour. But they don't want me for their regular music. No, they only want me for their Christmas music because they need somebody to play the bass clarinet.
Right. Bass clarinet. All right. Well, you guys sound fantastic. Thank you so much for doing this. I appreciate it. What's your next song?
Is it Calvin?
It is Calvin.
All right. Well, then here's another one of my arrangements that I worked up for this particular aggregate of musicians. Because we have so many singers in the group, I thought it would be fun, like I did with Old Fashioned, to work up a swing style, kind of Pied Pipers, Modernaires, I don't know. Swing arrangement of this Johnny Mercer classic, the old cowboy himself, Johnny Mercer, wrote, I'm an old cowhand, and I kind of reworked the lyrics a little bit because I ain't from the Rio Grande. I'm from Dakota Land.
Nice. So, all right, I'm going to let you have it.
Here we go. 1, 2, 3, and... I'm an old cowhand from Dakota land, and my legs ain't gold, and my cheeks ain't tanned. I'm a cowboy who's never saw a cow, never oped a steer, 'cause I don't know how. I sure ain't fixin' to start it now. Yippee-i-o-ki, yippee-i-o-ki. I'm an old cowhand from Dakota land, and I learned to ride, for I learned to stand. I know every trail in those Midwest states, 'cause my GPS maps are up to date. Someone drives me around in a Ford V8.
Yippee-i-o-ki. Yippee-i-o-ki.
Amen! Dakota land.
And he comes to town.
When I come to town.
Just to hear the band.
You know I love to hear the band.
He knows all the songs that the cowboys know about the big corral where the donkeys go.
'Cause I learned them all on my radio.
Yippee-i-o-ki-yay.
There's no way I'm not coming up after that. That was awesome. That was incredible. So that had to have a score like 6 miles long for those harmonies. That was awesome.
I didn't write it down in music. I just sang that part.
Just sang it all out.
Yeah, I just sang out their
parts. Well, that's good because I wouldn't have been able to read it anyhow. So,
yeah, well, you know, exactly. So. I mean, I could have put it in Braille, but they can't read Braille worth a damn, you know, so it's kind of like...
You can't win, can you, Rory? You just can't win. Guys, you sound fantastic. This is awesome. I'm really enjoying it. I thank everybody for being online from the shop. What's your next tune? I'm not going to talk a lot, but I have to talk after certain songs. I just felt compelled to tell you what an awesome job that was. Because we don't have an audience, and there should be about 1,000 people watching you right now.
Why did you tell me? I just thought they were all really so enraptured by what they heard.
Yeah, they're speechless.
Yeah. He just thought we just weren't going over.
So he's playing extra hard. All right, 50 Shades of Hay, everybody.
All right, this is an old Buddy Holly song, an old rock and roll song, and we send this one out to our good friend Mo. We haven't seen Mo in a few weeks, so we hope he's doing good. We'll send this one out to him. He has a crush on Wendy. He fancies Wendy, and he's figured out very smartly that the way he can get to chat up Wendy is to get David drunk and buy him lots of drinks. Remove David, he's happy. Mo's happy, and Wendy is...
Am I happy?
She's not complaining. We'll say that.
You get a
what
drink, too.
What about me?
We hope you're happy, Wendy. All right, this is called I Guess It Doesn't Matter Anymore.
Music. All right, 50 Shades of Hay. Whose idea was it to do that one? Was it yours?
That was mine, and we needed some rock and roll.
Yeah, I figured you had to have some rock and roll. Rock and roll mandolin, that's right, everybody. Well, I just want to say, you know, actually, we need to let everybody know where to find your music. That's what we need to know.
Well, our website is 50shadesofhayband.com. We are on Facebook. Same address, end of the address, 50 Shades of Hay Band. We are on Instagram, 50 Shades of Hay Band. We're on Spotify. We're on all the streaming platforms, right?
Yeah.
And we sell CDs out of the back of my car.
Of course. I mean,
and hey,
to.
We're even in, our CDs are in the Ernest Tubb Record Shop.
Oh, nice, nice.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't even know
who named the band?
David Spicher did.
Yeah.
I didn't even know that. You didn't know that. Yeah, I know. We gotta get to the heart of it now.
It was a text message chain, if I remember correctly.
Was it really?
I think so.
How did it happen? Just give us the rundown real quick.
Well, I came home after a hard day at Roberts and found Wendy in the bed, snuggled up to a Kindle book, smiling.
Oh, well, yeah. Yeah, you should have been worried at that point because anybody who read that book, you know.
That's how it started.
I read all three of them.
Oh, man. Wow. So you guys, like 150 shades of hay. So you just said, what was the conversation? I got to know. Yeah, this is worth knowing.
It's getting almost hard to remember, to be honest. But again,
there were a lot of, like, I don't even remember the other band name suggestions. But as soon as he said 50 Shades of Hay, I think we were all like, yeah, that's hilarious,
that's,
and memorable.
Awesome. Yeah, oh yeah, who's going to forget that?
Right.
Or the book. All right, 50 Shades of Hay, everybody.
Which was next. Was,
I think,
Paul.
All right,
here we're going to do, for our next song, a Kris Kristofferson song called Loving Her Was Easier. I've seen the morning burning golden on the mountains in the sky. Aching with the feeling of the freedom of an eagle when she flies. Turning on the world the way she smiled upon my soul as I lay dying. Colors of the sunshine in the shadows of her eyes. Waking in the morning to the feeling of her fingers on my skin. Wiping out the traces of the people and the places I've been. Yesterday was something that I never thought of trying. Talking of tomorrow and the money, loving time we'd have to spend. Loving her was easier than anything I'll ever do again. Close together with a feeling that I've never known before in my time. She ain't ashamed to be a woman or afraid to be a friend. I don't know the answer to the easy way she opens every door in my. Dreaming was as easy as believing it was never gonna end. Loving her was easier than anything I'll ever do again. Together with a feeling that I've never known before in my time. She ain't ashamed to be a woman or afraid to be a friend. I don't know the answer. she opens every door in my mind. Dreaming was as easy as believing it was never gonna end. Loving her was easier than anything I'll ever do again. Loving her was easier than anything I'll ever do again.
I said I wasn't going to talk, but I have to talk again. So what made you pick that song, Paul?
Well, it's a song you don't hear a lot anymore.
Right.
But it was at one time a very popular standard.
Yeah.
Of course, Chris wrote it, and man, everybody and their uncle recorded it back in the day.
Sure.
Willie Nelson. The Glazer Brothers had a version with harmony. And that's what caught my ear again. We need to do this song.
It's funny because my dad loves that song. That's his favorite song of all time.
Really?
And when you said you were doing it, I was like, oh, I got to say something about this.
Yeah.
And it's the Glazer Brothers version that I knew and I love. Of course,
yes.
Chris Christopherson, it doesn't get any better anyhow. But that was a great song, and the harmonies were spot on, guys. I absolutely love it. So what's next?
What's next is a song that's on our record, and it's a true story about my favorite cocktail, which is orange vodka and cranberry juice.
Really?
Although I've recently discovered a favorite strawberry soda with strawberry-flavored vodka. That's also good.
Well, we need to figure out everybody's favorite drinks, because I've never heard of that one. What's yours?
We just got a new song for the
beer.
Next album.
Yeah. All right, we'll stop it right there. Thanks, Eamon. 50 Shades of Hay, everybody.
This is called Too Much Vodka.
One, two, three, four.
That morning sun shines like a knife in my eye. My shirt's on backwards and I wish I knew why. It feels like I heard a wild horse running through my head. Telling the truth, just ask. this time. From now on, I'm drinking wine, 'cause I had too much vodka in my cranberry juice. Well, it's not my fault that they went down so smooth, that after 5 or 6, I started telling the truth. Just ask my crazy girlfriends if you need some proof. But I suppose things might have gone a little too far when somebody double-doctored me to get up on the bar. And today my equilibrium ain't working quite right, 'cause I had too much fun.
That's awesome. Did you write that?
I did, with my friend Larry Wayne Clark.
That is awesome. I heard tequila in there. Somebody hit the tequila lick. Yeah. I was like,
we stole. You know, Chris Casello used to always do that. He used to put that in every song.
Every song. Really? Oh my God, that's funny. So, have you ever pitched that song? Has anybody ever had that on hold?
Our friend Martha Healy, who is a great Scottish singer-songwriter. She recorded that song, and our friend Belinda Hansen from Sweden has been performing that in her shows, so maybe it'll be a worldwide
hit.
Yeah,
yeah. Do people try to order your orange vodka cranberry for you now when they hear that song?
Yeah, when...
Frank Townsend?
No, it's funny because we'll do that song at the Palace, and, you know... Every Nashville club, you know, you're passing the tip jug once an hour. So I'll be out on my tip jug pass, and I'll see a vodka cranberry on the on the table, and it's usually a woman because, you know, it's Kool-Aid with a kick. It's a girly drink, sure. And she'll say, "I got this."
Thanks
because
for that, Wendy. Thanks. Yeah, like I don't drink them ever. No, go ahead.
They'll say, "I tried your drink because of your song, and I love it." And so it's I'm helping women and men, one drink at a time.
That's right. Well, that's awesome. I love that song. Okay, what's next?
All yodeling.
Well, here comes a song all about the dangers of yodeling. It's a cautionary tale. It's called Yodeling in My Sleep.
50 Shades of Hay, everybody.
The story how I came out west is really a humdinger. They classified and said they need a fiddling cowboy singer. But what it failed to mention and what's given me conniptions, knowing how to yodel was part of the job description. Well, you might think it's no big deal to learn a little yodel, but the truth is it takes lots of time tuning up your tonsils. So now I spend the wee small hours spinning on my mattress. I'm trying to catch the Z train, but my brain still wants to practice. I'm yodeling in my sleep, and I would not recommend it. I should be counting sheep like the good shepherd intended. This trying to teach an old tongue new tricks has got me weeping, 'cause I'm yodeling in my sleep when I ought to be just sleeping. Howdy ole oodle-o, eddy oodle-o, eddy oodle-o, ootee. Howdy ole oodle-o, eddy oodle-o, ootee. So now you know the story of my sorry situation. Instead of sawing logs, I'm logging hours of frustration. Not
nocturnal mental tape loops I no longer find amusing. Listen up, folks, don't you mix your yodeling and your snoozing. I'm yodeling in my sleep and I would not recommend it. I should be counting sheep like the good shepherd intended. This trying to teach a no-tongue new tricks has got me weeping, 'cause I'm yodeling in my sleep when I ought to be just sleeping. Ain't moping, I'm just hoping that the Sandman soon comes creeping, 'cause I'm yodeling in my sleep when I ought to be just sleeping. Adio, lay you low, lady, you low, lady, you low, tea, lady, you low, tea, lady, you low, tea, adio, lady, you low, lady, you low, low, lady, you low, tea, adio, lady, you low, lady, you low, tea, adio, lady, you low, lady, you low. In my sleep.
Who did that one, Paul?
I wrote that.
You wrote that. Uh-huh. I was gonna say, did you really?
Yes, I
That's
did.
That's fantastic, man. That's awesome.
I had a fill-in gig with the Riders in the Sky. I got to be Woody Paul for a day, so I told them just call me Would Be Paul. and I was, you know, trying to learn their material, of course. And
yeah.
And then I got to yodeling in my sleep, so I thought I'd write a song about it.
So it was inspired by true events.
True events.
Wow. What if you were, like, reading 50 Shades of Hay? 50 50
Yodels of Day.
It'd be a different song, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
What is it? 50 Shades of Gray, right? Is it,
right,
yeah,
right.
Yeah, yeah, 50, yeah. I'm so used to saying 50 Shades of Hay. Yeah, something like that, yeah. Whatever it is. That's awesome. That's a great song, man. Yeah.
Thank you.
And harmony yodeling. You gotta love that. Everybody loves that. All right. So, I need to take a second and thank Donnie Eden Prosperity Mortgage. Donnie, thank you so much for sponsoring the show. We appreciate it. And the Colorado Grill, our new sponsor. How's dinner?
Wonderful.
Great.
Right?
Great.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Thank you so much, Colorado Grill. We do appreciate it right here in White House, Tennessee. Go see him. Food was delicious. All right. What's next?
I'm going to do one off the record. It's a traditional summer. We think it came from Ireland, possibly. It's been used as a war song. The Girl I Left Behind Me. It's, you know, reminiscent of, like, what, you know, the girl waiting for me back home.
Right.
Did I treat her right? Did I treat her wrong? I don't get into that.
I was going to say, how deep does it go?
It's not so deep at all. Just me walking down the road thinking about her. That's all.
Oh, okay. So green grass of homish kind of thing.
Yeah. But
no prison.
But with a little lilt to it. Yes.
Oh, nice. All right.
We're going to pep it up.
50 Shades of Hay.
Yeah, awesome. And ringlets fair, her eyes like diamonds shine, and her slender waist and heavenly face that keeps my heart still pining. Oh God above, please hear my prayer that good luck should find me and send me safely home again to the girl I left behind me. I wrote her a letter, I should have known better. I asked her to be my wife. Along came a feller, he hit me in the smeller, it nearly cost me my life. Oh, that girl, that pretty little girl, the girl I left behind me, with rosy cheeks and curly hair, the girl I left behind me. I rode ahead to the place where she said, and there on a note you'll read, I'll always be true, and when you're through, you come home and you will find me. Oh, that girl, that pretty little girl, the girl I left behind me, with rosy cheeks and curly hair, the girl I left behind me. Last night I slept in the wind and rain with a sycamore all around me. Tonight I'll sleep in a warm feather bed with the girl I left behind me. Oh, that girl, that pretty little girl, the girl I left behind me. With rosy cheeks and curly hair, the girl I left behind me. Oh, that girl, that pretty little girl, the girl I left behind me. With rosy cheeks and curly hair, the girl I left behind me.
Not the green, green grass at home, by the way, just so you know. Yeah, no wonder you were like, yeah, no, not at all. No, I'm sorry. I don't want to call you out. Guys, I have really enjoyed this. I know we got time for one more song. So tell everybody where they can find you, because you need to be booked like everywhere on earth. You can book this band, right?
Yes, you can totally book us. Yeah. 50shadesofheyband@gmail.com. That's how you send us an email and ask us to do a gig.
They can just send us money if they want to.
Yeah, I mean, that would be the best way to
PayPal,
do it.
PayPal, Venmo, yeah.
Maybe absolutely. They can't get out of the house right now, and that's cool.
Yeah.
They could still, it'd be like a private concert.
Well, I mean, that's the way it is nowadays, you know. But, I mean, you know, you'll play backyard parties and whatever else.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
We've done backyard parties. We did two this year.
Did you?
We did.
Yeah, I know that sounds low.
It's been a year.
It's been a year for that, for sure. Well, I know you guys got one more. Was it Bob Wills?
Yeah,
oh, man. I just want to say thank you, guys. This is awesome. Thanks
thank
for
you.
Doing this. It's fantastic, and I hope everybody out there will buy the music, look up the band, book the band, whatever you need to do, because they're incredible. 50 Shades of Hay. Thanks, guys.
It's okay. He can eat an apple pie and never even bat an eye. He likes everything from soup to hay. Roly-poly, he's daddy's little fatty. Bet he's gonna be a man someday. Amen. everything from soup to hay. Roly poly, he's daddy's little fatty. Bet he's gonna swing a band someday.
That was fantastic. 50 Shades of Hey, everybody, live from the shop. Thank you again, Eamon, Rory, Wendy, Paul, Xander, David. Appreciate you guys all being here. Make sure you look them up. One more time, the website?
50 Shades of Hey Band. That's 50shadesofheyband.com.
Awesome. Thank you to Prosperity Mortgage, Colorado Grill, and we'll see you next week. Sarah Simmons on Live from the Shop. 50 Shades of Hey, everybody.
Bye.